Heading out. To the studio. It's finally underway. Heading to the studio to hopefully be one of two final face parts. And I have my crew here with me. Say yes, what's up? Gio doesn't know he's on. This is a video, you're going on YouTube later. And the main guy here. Oh wait, I can't get him. There he is, look at that handsome. Gorgeous, gorgeous pasta. He hates being on camera, everybody. He's just gonna have to get used to it because he's a part of my life and so. Can't. But yeah, so we're on our way to the producer's house and it's gonna be a lot of things underway, a lot of things discussed today. I know a lot of you guys have been asking when I was coming out with either more covers or new songs or anything like that, and this right here is part of the next project coming up. So hopefully soon you will be getting getting some further updates as to what's going on, and yeah, excited to take you guys on this journey with me. And we'll see what's to come. So a lot of you guys have left me some really beautiful comments about Curtis. He was the first and up to now last person that I ever did a cover with, meaning, you know, singing with. I've done other covers, but it was just me singing by myself. I think it's needless to say that, you know, I miss him very much. You know, for a lot of you guys, a lot of you guys happen to come to my channel or stumble upon my channel through Michelle, also known as Love Michelle Anna. Love Michelle Anna is her channel. And just a quick, you know, background to how we know each other. I've known Michelle since she was a baby. Her sister was in my wedding. She was my maid of honor. And so we've known each other forever, we're family. And obviously I met Curtis through Michelle. You know, I met him when he first, you know, when they were first dating and all of that. So we were there for the wedding and I sang at their wedding actually. I'll never forget that. And a lot of good memories. Curtis, as you all know the story, or maybe some of you don't know, but they after they got married, they moved to South Carolina, and after moving back, they became members of our church, and Curtis has always been a worshiper. He always loved to sing, and more than singing, he just loved God and loved to worship, and so of course, it wasn't a surprise when he expressed his desire to be part of the worship team, and that happened. And we are a bilingual church. Not I shouldn't say bilingual. We have an English congregation and English speaking congregation, and we also have a Spanish speaking congregation. And there are times, sometimes during throughout the year where we have United Services, where those services are bilingual. And Curtis just fit in perfectly. Like, he just had no problem singing in the Spanish service. He was quick learner, just loved by everybody. And then on a personal level, he just was someone that I grew to love and care for very deeply. You know, as the Lord started opening doors of opportunity for me personally to minister in other places, I would always ask him, like, Curtis, can you come with me? And he would always say yes. And he never said no. He never said no. He was always there. My gosh. There's a post that I have put up, and I think I'll probably insert it here, where I literally took like I made a collage of pictures where I'm ministering in different places, and there's Curtis in the background. He was like my ride or die, you know? And even in church for prayer services, you know, I have a recording of him and I where we led a prayer service. It's what we call harp and bowl. If you guys haven't heard of it, it's the concept of integrating prayer with worship, or intercession, I should say, with worship. And one of our engineers, our audio engineers, he has on file a recording of Curtis and I. It was just him and I that night. And we ministered the whole thing. And I still to this day have not been able to listen to it because I don't feel like I'm ready. But I know one day I will listen to it soon. But that was just the kind of, you know, relationship we had. It was just very, we were sensitive to the voice of God. Like, I didn't even have to look at him, and he already knew where I was going. And just, he was an incredible, incredible, credible person. You know, a friend, a co-minister with me, and the rest of us. Because, I mean, there's also a team and obviously a community. But I'm speaking from my personal experience, obviously. And anyway, there's a couple of reasons why I wanted to share all this with you guys, is because I know that a lot of you came across my channel because of Curtis's story. So I thought it was appropriate to kind of give you that little background, a bit of that background, to know like how we connected, you know. And that's one reason. And another reason is because Curtis, part of, When I do things like what I'm doing today, like pursuing a dream or pursuing a goal or pursuing something that I know that God has for me for this season that I'm supposed to be doing despite fear and despite doubt or despite anything, I think of Curtis, because Curtis was like the best. If you needed a cheerleader, like, man, all you had to do was call Curtis. And Curtis was like one of my, aside from my husband, he was one of my greatest cheerleaders and supporters, you know. He made you feel like, if there were days you felt like you couldn't do it, he would definitely make you believe it by the end of the day, or, you know, by the end of your conversation with him. And one of the very recent things that he had told me before his passing is that he told me, you inspire me. I think I had started doing like a Periscope, you know, occasionally on like voice hygiene and vocal hygiene. You know, I was just stepping out of my comfort zone to do certain things, and he was watching, and he said to me, man, you really have inspired me to just do things that I've been so scared to do. And so he picked up his guitar and he started doing all these, like, he said he was gonna start doing all these, like, you know, projects that he wanted to do. And I just really, really miss him. You know, I miss him a lot, but I know that God's thoughts and ways are higher than ours, and God knows best. He knows best, and he's not here. You know, it stings, but it's what God had in store, and it's been a process for all of us, the church community, his family, his close friends. But it's a bittersweet thing, because we know where he is, and we know that his short time here on earth was so impactful to so many people. And I'm just so honored and so blessed to say that I was a part of his life, you know, and I'll forever be grateful for that.
It's all in your hands. So-